I'm your captain. It's going down. I'm your captain now. It's going down. 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 I'm your captain now. It's going down. 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 This is how you start a fresh rap with a new track. Put your seat.
Ladies and gentlemen, start your engines and get ready for a deep dive into the history and culture of motorcycles. It all began in 1885 when Gottlieb Daimler, a German engineer, strapped an engine to a wooden bicycle and created the first motorcycle. While that original machine may not have been as advanced as the ones we have today, it was the spark that ignited a passion in people all over the world. Throughout the years, motorcycles evolved from clunky, unreliable machines to sleek, powerful beasts. As technology improved, so too did the culture surrounding them. Riding a motorcycle is more than just transportation. It's a way of life. It's about the feeling of freedom and adventure that comes with the open road and the sense of camaraderie among riders. After the invention of the first motorcycle in 1885, the industry began to grow like a biker's beard. In 1901, the first V-twin engine was developed, which would become a staple in motorcycle design for many years to come. This new engine design allowed for more power and speed, and it quickly became popular among riders looking for a more exciting riding experience. Or in simpler terms, it was like upgrading from a tricycle to a rocket ship. In the early 1900s, motorcycles were primarily used for transportation, but as the industry evolved, they began to be used for racing as well. The first official motorcycle race was held in 1902, and by the 1920s, motorcycle racing had become a popular sport. This led to further advancements in technology as manufacturers competed to create faster and more powerful bikes. It's like a game of one-upmanship, but with motorcycles. During World War II, motorcycles played a vital role in transportation for the military. Many companies halted their civilian production and focused on building motorcycles for the armed forces. This period also marked the emergence of new technologies such as telescopic forks and swing arm rear suspension, which greatly improved the handling and stability of motorcycles. We can only imagine the German soldiers thinking, "Well, this is a game changer," when they saw the new suspension systems. In the post-war period, motorcycle sales boomed as returning veterans sought to continue the sense of freedom and adventure they had experienced during their military service. The 1950s and 60s saw the emergence of new subcultures, such as the greasers and the rockers, who were often associated with the nascent outlaw biker culture because what's cooler than a leather jacket and a hog? In the 1970s, the industry faced challenges with increasing competition and changing consumer preferences. But it's like they say, what doesn't kill a motorcycle culture makes it stronger. The motorcycle culture is known for its sense of individuality and self-expression. Each rider has their own unique style and personality, whether they're a leather-clad biker or an urban commuter. Each subculture has their own way of expressing themselves through their bikes, clothing, and riding style. From the Harley-Davidson crowd, known for their love of loud pipes and leather jackets, to the sport bike crowd, known for their love of speed and tight turns, to the cruiser crowd, known for their love of laid-back, easy-going rides, and let's not forget the scooter crowd, known for their love of convenience and fuel efficiency. Each group has their own unique style and personality. But at the end of the day, they're all part of the same motorcycle culture. As the popularity of motorcycles grew, so too did the sense of community. From local riding groups to international motorcycle clubs, riders have formed tight-knit communities, united by their love for the open road. It's not just about the ride itself, it's about the bond shared among riders, the sense of adventure and the feeling of freedom. Motorcycle culture has a strong tradition of freedom and rebellion, often depicted in movies, music and literature. This romanticized image of the open road and the outlaw biker which has become an integral part of the culture. But it's not just about the thrills and spills. Riding a motorcycle has its practical benefits as well. Motorcycles are more cost-effective and fuel-efficient than cars. They're also great for city driving, as they can weave through traffic and take advantage of smaller parking places. They are also more environmentally friendly, producing fewer emissions than cars. riding a motorcycle can also be physically and mentally beneficial, as it's a great way to get some vitamin D, wind therapy, and the mindfulness that comes with being fully present in the moment. It's also a great way to clear the mind and release stress. It's considered a form of therapy. It's important to note that, as with any form of transportation, motorcycle riding comes with risks and responsibilities. Safety is key, and riders must always wear protective gear and obey traffic laws to minimize the risk of accidents. Regular maintenance is also crucial to ensure the safety and longevity of the bike. In conclusion, motorcycle culture is a rich tapestry of history, community, freedom, and adventure. It's a culture that has stood the test of time and continues to evolve. Whether you're a seasoned rider or a curious newcomer, embrace the culture and join the brotherhood or sisterhood of the open road. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, because we'll be taking more trips down memory lane and exploring all things motorcycles. Ride safe, ride hard, and ride in style. Remember that motorcycle culture is not just about the bike, it's about the lifestyle, the attitude, and the sense of belonging. It's a way of life that will bring you joy, freedom, and adventure for as long as you ride.